here we go, guys. Cam online. Just waiting on SpaceX, and we'll go live. Or we're live, but they'll go live. There we go, guys.
Thank you. Ice launch checked on countdown.net. Pad is clear.
10, 9, 8.
Launch auto sequence has started.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Go for launch.
Vehicle is supersonic.
Stage separation confirmed. Dragon, separation confirmed.
Stage one is transonic. Landing leg has deployed. And Falcon 9 has landed.
You're looking at a live view of Falcon 9 as it prepares for liftoff at 12:27 a.m. Eastern.
Engine chill has started.
Good evening. My name is Jesse Anderson. I'm joining you today from SpaceX headquarters in Hawthorne, California. Today marks SpaceX's 26th launch of the year, and this will be a record third launch in less than 48 hours. For those of you following along, you know that Starlink lifted off from Kennedy Space Center Friday morning, followed by SARA-1 from Vandenberg Space Force Base about 14 hours ago. And now you're watching the launch of Global Star's FM-15 Spare satellite from Florida's Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. FM-15 is the 25th and last satellite in the second generation constellation. The other 24 satellites were launched in four campaigns throughout 2010 to 2013.
Stage one, RP-1 load is complete.
The second generation constellation was designed and manufactured by Thales Alenia Space, primarily in Cannes, France, and Rome, Italy. FM-15 will help extend the useful life of the second generation constellation and will ultimately provide service concurrent with Globalstar's new fleet of satellites procured by MDA and Rocket Lab, which is expected to launch in approximately 3 years. Now at T-minus 5 minutes and 40 seconds to go, conditions for liftoff today are looking pretty good. We do have 80% favorability for weather today at T-zero. The range is ready to support and is currently green for launch. And as you may be able to hear some of the sounds from the vehicle, we began loading our propellants on both stages of the vehicle at T-minus 35 minutes. And at the moment, the vehicle and payload are in good health. And speaking of the vehicle, Falcon 9 is a reusable two-stage rocket, which means that it's basically two rockets in one, the first and the second stage. Now, the bottom two-thirds of the vehicle is the first stage and is the primary part of the rocket that gets reused multiple times. The dark
Falcon 9 tanks are pressurizing for strong back retract.
The dark sit that you see around the lower part of the first stage are remnants from its previous 8 launches for this booster. And we will be attempting to recover the booster again today using our drone ship, which you see there on your screen. Just read the instructions. At the moment, the Globalstar FM-15 satellite is currently enclosed.
Strong back retract has started.
The Globalstar FM-15 satellite is currently enclosed in our payload fairing at the very top of the rocket, and that is what you see on your screen. The job of the fairing is to protect the satellite until we reach the vacuum of space. Once we're in space, we no longer need this protection, so we'll separate the fairing halves and attempt to retrieve them once they return back down to Earth. Now, for those of you who are interested in learning more about Falcon 9, be sure to check out our website, spacex.com, for more details. Now, we did hear the call out that the transporter erector, or what they called the strong back, is retracting. Now, the TE moves away from the vehicle to clear the way for Falcon 9 when it lifts off at T-zero. And there you can see, it's a little hard to see, but you can see the clamp arms are opened up and the transporter erector is retracted away from the vehicle. Now, if for some reason we are not able to launch today, we do have a backup opportunity on Monday at 12:05 a.m. Eastern time. Falcon 9 and the Globalstar FM-15 payload is lifting off from Pad 40 today. Space Launch Complex 40 is located in Florida at the north end of Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. Now, here's an interesting fact
about
the pad.
Stage one, locks load is complete.
And we just heard LOX load complete on the first stage.
And stage one, POGO.
Here's an interesting fact about Pad 40. Before SpaceX, Slick 40 was used by the United States Air Force to launch Titan vehicles from the mid-60s through Titan's retirement in 2005. Then Pad 40 was leased to SpaceX to support Falcon launches in 2007. And we are just under T-minus 3 minutes from T-zero. We did hear the call out that stage one LOX load is complete. Around the T-minus 2 minute mark will be when the LOX load completes on the second stage, and that will conclude propellant loading for both vehicles, for the Falcon 9 vehicle. And we're just about 15 seconds away from that call out.
Stage two, LOX load is complete.
And there's that call out. LOX loading is complete, which means that propellant loading on Falcon 9 is complete. So now that we have finished LOX loading, we are now venting out the liquid oxygen line on the transporter erector, and that is why you see...
Launch gas closeouts has started.
That's why you see those white clouds on your screen. And we are coming up on T-minus 1 minute. That will be when Falcon 9 is in startup. We should hear that call out for startup. And that's when the flight computers take over the launch countdown. This vehicle is autonomous, so at the T-minus 1 minute mark, the computers take over the vehicle.
Falcon 9 is in startup.
And there's that call out. Now just waiting for the final call from the launch director here in a few seconds.
LD, go for launch.
And great news, there is the go for launch. So all systems are go for Falcon 9 to take our Global Star FM-15 satellite out into space.
T-minus 30 seconds. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, ignition, and lift off of Falcon 9, go Falcon, go Global Star.
Vehicle is pitching downrange.
Stage 1, chamber pressure is nominal.
Falcon 9 has successfully lifted
power
off.
Power and telemetry are nominal.
Falcon 9 has successfully lifted off with Global Star FM-15 satellites and has throttled down to prepare for Max-Q. Max-Q is the highest amount of aerodynamic pressures that the vehicle sees during ascent, and is coming up
supersonic.
Here. Coming up here in a few seconds.
Max-Q.
Great call out that we've now passed through that period of maximum aerodynamic pressure. Next up will be three events, and they will be happening back to back from each other. That will be MECO, stage separation, and SES-1. MECO stands for main engine.
MVAC engine chill has started.
Great call-outs there. MECO stands for Main Engine Cutoff, and that is referring to the 9 Merlin engines on the first stage. And we've got a great view here. We should be able to see those 9 engines shut down, and that helps prepare for the second event, which is stage separation. That's where the first stage separates from the second stage. And the third event will be SES-1, which is where the second stage engine starts up for the first time on its journey today. And those three events, again, are MECO, stage separation, and SES-1 coming up here in just a few seconds.
Main engine cutoff.
Stage separation confirmed.
MVAC ignition.
And some great callouts there. We did just see MECO with the first stage engines shutting down, stage separation, and SES-1. We saw that startup of the MVAC engine on the second stage. Now, what you're seeing on your screen is a view of the first stage with the grid fins deploying there.
Acquisition signal, Bermuda.
Now, these grid fins are helping to steer the first stage back to its landing zone. Today is just read the instructions. Our drone ship waiting off the coast of Florida for this vehicle to return back home to Earth. And it is nighttime over there on the East Coast, so it is a bit dark. But you can see, this is a view of the first stage, and you can see some bursts of nitrogen. Those are those flashes that you see there, and that is used for attitude control, and that's what the vehicle...
Start of mid-flight guidance, stage 2 is on nominal trajectory.
Good call-outs with stage 2. But those nitrogen bursts are what the vehicle uses to help guide the vehicle back to its landing zone. And in order to complete landing today, the first stage, we'll have 2 more burns left. Next up will be the entry burn, and that's where 3 of the 9 Merlin engines will reignite. And that helps to slow the vehicle down as it re-enters the upper parts of the Earth's atmosphere. That burn is about a 20-second burn. After it shuts down, the atmosphere actually helps grab most of the velocity on the first stage. So when we get closer to landing, we only need a single engine burn for the landing burn, and that's the single E9 engine in the center of the vehicle. Now we are just about 3 minutes away from the entry burn beginning on the first stage. And as I previously mentioned, you could see on the vehicle the soot markings that were left over from previous flights. And just a quick explanation of how that happens, the rocket grade kerosene, or RP1, used to fuel Falcon 9 is carbon based. And so when it burns, it generates the soot. And as I was talking about the entry burn, the vehicle enters back into the Earth's atmosphere, engines first. So when we do reignite those engines, that's how the soot gets back onto the vehicle, is because it is basically flying through its own plume.
Stage 2 on nominal trajectory.
And stage 2 is on a nominal trajectory. For today's mission, we do have 3 burns of the MVAC engine in order to make its way to its drop-off orbit for the satellite today. Now, we were able to see the grid fins on the first stage just for a quick few seconds. Falcon 9 is equipped with four hypersonic grid fins positioned near the top of the first stage, which is near the base of the inner stage. And that's what the vehicle uses for steering as it makes its way back to
stage
Earth.
Stage 2 FTS is saved.
And they help orient the rocket during re-entry and guide the vehicle during its descent. And again, today we will be attempting to land on our drone ship. Just read the instructions. If you're just now joining us, we did have a successful liftoff from pad 40 at 12:27 a.m. Eastern time. We had a successful MECO stage separation and second stage engine start. And we have been hearing good callouts of the first stage, second stage trajectory. Again, today we will have three ignitions of our MVAC engine. And actually today, during the landing burn, we will have the first SECO 1, which is second stage engine cutoff 1. So we'll have a couple
call outs. Stage 2 on nominal trajectory.
Stage 1, FTS is saved.
Stage 1, entry burn startup.
And great news. And as you can see on your screen, the entry burn has begun for the first stage. This will last about 20 seconds long. Again, this is helping slow the vehicle down as it's entering back into the Earth's atmosphere.
Acquisition signal, Newfoundland.
Stage 1, entry burn shutdown.
And as the screen goes dark, that means that those engines have shut down, and we did hear the call out for entry burn shutdown. And we are about less than a minute away from the landing burn beginning on the first stage. And as I was mentioning, the landing burn conclusion will happen around the same time as SECO 1 on second stage. That is second engine cutoff 1. We're just about 20 seconds away from the landing burn beginning. Again, it's just the center E9 engine that ignites for landing. And each one of these Merlin engines has about 190,000 pounds of thrust, and that's just enough.
Terminal guidance.
It's just enough to help the vehicle slow down and touch down for landing.
Stage 1 landing burn.
And there's that call out, stage 1 landing burn. Now the four landing legs should deploy just a few seconds before touchdown. So let's watch as Falcon 9 attempts to land on just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
And
stage 1 landing confirmed.
Awesome view. Stage 1 has landed. This marks our 126th overall successful recovery of an orbital class rocket. And that includes Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy first stage landings. And we just heard the call out for a nominal orbital insertion on the second stage. So with that, we are going to be in a coast phase until just before we relight the MVAC engine again on the second stage. So sit back and enjoy the space jams, and we'll see you just after the T plus 1 hour mark.
Thank you. there and look at the rockets from Mars, and you just boggle the mind and mind and mind and mind. And the technology caught up, didn't it?
Welcome back to the webcast for the launch of Globalstar FM15. We had an on-time liftoff from Florida's Cape Canaveral Space Force Station at 12:27 a.m. Eastern Time and a successful landing of our first stage booster off the coast of Florida. FM15 is the 25th and last satellite in the second generation constellation. The other 24 satellites were launched in four campaigns throughout 2010 to 2013. The second generation constellation was designed and manufactured by Thales Alenia Space, primarily in Cannes, France, and Rome, Italy. And we are now currently awaiting the relight of our second stage engine in just a few seconds here. And there we got a quick view of SES-2 and SECO-2 on that MVAC engine. And we did hear the call out for confirmation of good orbit. So before we deploy the FM-15 satellite for our customer Globalstar, we have a third and final ignition of our second stage MVAC engine. We are expecting this relight in about 40 minutes. Until then, we're going to leave you with a map showcasing where we are in the mission. We'll see you soon.
Nominal orbit insertion.
The technology caught up to them.
and expect to lose the signal, Tasmania. Acquisition, signal of Vandenberg. We'll be right back.
thanks for tuning in to watch the Globalstar FM-15 mission. We had an on-time liftoff from Florida's Cape Canaveral Space Force Station at 12:27 a.m. Eastern Time, and a successful landing of our first stage booster off the coast of Florida. Now, we're currently waiting the final relight of our second stage engine in just a few seconds. And there we have had a short burn, SES-3 and SECO-3, which is second stage engine cutoff. And we are just waiting for confirmation of good orbit. If you're just now joining us, we just concluded the third burn of the MVAC engine on the second stage, and we are just waiting.
Orbit insertion.
And there it is, that call out for confirmation of good orbit. Now up next, at about T plus 1 hour and 53 minutes, will be the deploy of the Globalstar FM-15 satellite. So we'll see you back here just before to catch payload separation. You're watching the live webcast for the Globalstar FM-15 mission, which lifted off from Launch Pad 40 at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station almost 2 hours ago now. And we are now waiting for the deployment of the 25th and final satellite in the second generation constellation.
Globalstar, separation confirmed.
An awesome view. You can see the Globalstar FM-15 satellite drifting away from Falcon 9's second stage. With a successful deployment of the Globalstar FM-15 satellite, that will bring our webcast to a close. We want to thank our customer for entrusting us with tonight's mission. This launch completes a record 3-mission triple header in less than 48 hours. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.